Using the problem steps recorder. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. The problem steps recorder is exactly what its name implies. It's a way to record the steps you take when you reproduce a problem in such a way that you can share it with someone else, like your friendly neighborhood question and answer site. Let me show you exactly how it works. So we're here in Windows 11, although the PSR Problem Steps Recorder exists in both Windows 10 and Windows 11. What I'm going to do is just run PSR. That is probably the easiest way to have it start up. Now you'll notice that not a lot happens other than this little window shows up. The little window is in fact the Problem Steps Recorder's user interface, if you will. All you really need to do now is click Start Record. When you click Start Record, Windows, or actually the PSR, is now recording each of the steps you take moving forward. I'll show you what that looks like in a minute, but right now it's recording what I do. So if I click on the Start button and I then click on Notepad and I type in some text and I close Notepad, saving the file. Now we hit Stop and Review. PSR now brings up a list or a window of all of the steps we've taken to essentially duplicate our problem. I didn't have a problem this time. It was just showing you exactly how this works. But if we now scroll through this, you'll see that here's the very first thing it recorded. User left click on the Start button. That's what I did. You can add a comment if you like. So here's a screenshot of the screen, the entire screen at the time I did that click. Then it said, user left click on desktop list in Start. That actually is the step where I clicked on the notepad icon in the Start menu. Scroll down a little further, there's another screenshot with Notepad highlighted. One of the things I want to point out here is this green rectangle you see in Notepad. What that's indicating is which window has the focus. In other words, if I start typing or if I start doing something, it's the window with the green rectangle that is going to get that input. That actually is useful information when trying to diagnose a problem later on. This then says user keyboard input. Well, that's me typing into Notepad. Scrolling down some more, user left click on some text notepad window. That is the window. That's the title of the notepad window. Scrolling down some more, I clicked on the save button in some text notepad. That's saving the file in response to my attempting to close the program. And then, of course, the user clicked on the save button, save as, and we're done. That's when I stopped recording. Now you'll notice that not absolutely every little thing was recorded. For example, it didn't record me clicking on the close button. It didn't record the specifics of my mouse movement. It just showed what I was clicking on and what the screen looked like at the time I clicked on it. So that's what goes into a PSR recording. Now, let's make it useful. If I now hit save, it will give me an opportunity to save that recording as a zip file. And I'll just call it example.zip. That then is what you would share with whomever it is you're perhaps trying to get help from, right? This will show them exactly step by step what it is you did to duplicate whatever problem it is you're having. So what are they going to get? Because that's actually a little bit different than what we're seeing here. I'm going to go ahead and close the steps recorder now. So I'll fire up Windows File Explorer and then navigate to the folder in which I actually saved that zip file. Here it is, example.zip. I'm going to double click on it so we can see what's inside. And inside is a .mht file. What that is essentially it's an HTML file. It's intended to be opened by a web browser. That then includes all of the images, all of the text, everything that was visible in that web page when it was displayed. Most web browsers can view these, though not all can. Edge, of course, can, and it will do so in what it calls Internet Explorer compatibility mode. I'm going to go ahead and copy that to a different folder. So I'm now going to double click on the MHT file so that it opens up in Microsoft Edge. And you can see that it includes all of the images and the steps that we were looking at in the Problem Steps Recorder. This is a package that you would then give to somebody else so that they can see exactly what it is you did to duplicate the problem at hand. One important caveat here that is very easy to overlook, and that is simply this. As you can see from the information in the recorded steps, it's taking screenshots. It's taking full screenshots along the way, at each step along the way. What that means is all of the information on your screen is going to be included whether it applies to the problem you're duplicating or not. That in turn means that, well, whoever you give this to help you will be able to see all that. That means then is that you probably want to make sure to close all of the parenting programs that you can that aren't associated with the problem you're trying to reproduce, and that you're absolutely positive nothing of a personal nature is going to be on the screen as you do this. No passwords is the big one, but anything else you might consider to be personal of nature, you want to make sure is closed or off screen or whatever. But the bottom line here is that this is an incredibly useful tool to get problem steps recorded in such a way that somebody else may be able to help you. One sidebar about Ask Leo specifically. When you submit a question at askleo.com/ask, there is not an opportunity to attach anything. There's no upload button. You can't attach a screenshot or anything like that. However, when you submit a question, you'll get an automated response in email that confirms we've gotten your question and that it's in our system. You can reply to that email with an attachment. And of course, in the past, that's been screenshots. However, if it's helpful, you can attach the zip file that is the result of a Problem Steps Recorder session. That'll probably help me understand a little bit better exactly what it is you're trying to solve. So I hope that's helpful. I hope that gives you an extra tool for being able to get help and correctly explain exactly what the heck is happening to whatever problem it is you're trying to resolve. For updates, for links, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/162248. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.